Hi folks, let's get to the tutorial on how to operate the VEN Spray ONE painting machine. Once you have connected the machine, the main switch is on and you look at the display. You should see this picture here. The picture shows you the simplified representation of the machine. Switching on would be here with on, the off button. Furthermore, you can see here the manual operation. What else can you do? For example, you can adjust the transport speed, move the gun carrier back and forth, move it to the middle, and you can test each single spray gun to see if it works if there is paint present. You can exit the menu in this way. Then you look over this menu. What kind of messages do I have pending? Warnings, malfunction messages, or any messages? As you can see, there are 4 messages displayed at the moment, but we are not interested at the moment. We go out and back again. Here we have the same thing again with the messages. Let's go out again, let's go back. We can call up recipes, pre-stored recipes, or recipes that you create yourselves. My colleague Sarah can tell you something about this. She knows a little bit more about it than I do. There we go back again. In the last step, we have a menu with the topic, reading the operating hours. How long has the machine been running? If you have big problems with the machine, you could contact the Venjakob service. But of course, this will never happen because once the machine is running, it runs. We can go out there again. Let's see what else our colleague Sarah has to say. Thank you.
Thanks also to my colleague Ollie, who has already shown us a little bit of the user interface. I will now go into more detail about the recipes. We will now go to the tab Recipes for the first time. So, here you can already see a few recipes that we created during the test of this VEN Spray ONE. But you will only find one recipe. This is the one at the very beginning with the name Test. And if you want to create your own recipe, you have to copy the recipe test because there are standard parameters in it which you absolutely need. Well, let's go to copy. There you have the tabs name, number, and text. Here we put a door red as example and confirm that. Now we have our own recipe called Test 1. That's what we'll see. Then we go to the pen button. Here we cannot change the recipe parameters yet. We can only change the name, the number, and a short note of the recipe. So, after creating the recipe, I noticed that this recipe is not used with a green but with a red paint. I can note this here in the note or the recipe name. Okay, we've done all that now. Now we really want to get started. So, we load the recipe. Now it's uploaded. Now it's displayed in dark blue so we know, okay, we can start. Then we go to our overview. Up there, it already says Test 1. All right, this is our recipe. Let's get started. At the beginning, we have 4 tabs here. One with the names Cabin, Guns, Cleaning, and Parts Detector. We're just going to start with Cabin. There's the gun drive, which we can adjust. Then the double strokes. That is how fast our axle moves back and forth, how fast we want to paint. Here, I adjust this from 18 to 20. Then we want to enter the curve circumference. Now this small field appears, telling us that our user level is not sufficient to adjust it. The parameters that have been set there have to be sufficient for us now. Then we can swipe one more page here. Here we still have the air balance. We can adjust the air supply. I'll just adjust this from 50% to 60%. We can do the same with the exhaust air. The follow-up time is preset. That's another fixed parameter. We don't have to bother with that. It's already set. All right, next, we're going to do the spray gun tab. First, we have the operating mode. We can see we're at gun 1, whether we want it on or off. We turn ours on now. And then we can see whether we want to let it spray, pulling or pushing. Depending on it, the field that was just selected is shown in dark blue. Then there are also little hooks up here. This is pulling now, for example. And with the other one, we now have pulling and pushing depending on what you want to do. Next is the spray gun offset. There we can adjust left and right. That is, if we change the guns a little bit in the angle of the degrees. Then we have to adjust the offset in any case. The spray gun start is also very important for us. The first gun starts spraying sooner than the rear guns, which also depends on the light barrier that detects the parts that pass through it. The last bit is the overspray valves. We adjust this if we have edges, high edges, low edges, so that the spray guns start painting sooner or run on after longer. Of course, we have four different ones, but that was only for spray gun number one. The tabs for guns number 2 to number 4 look the same. You can adjust them all individually. So, next tab. This is the cleaning. Here we have our winding drive, which should always be switched on. This is better for the belt because otherwise you will contaminate it. In addition to that is the standby traction. This has all been preset for us, so we can start right away. Last but not least, there is the parts detector. Actually, there is not much to say about that. There is the gun drive and the winding drive. Both can't be set by us. It's all been done for us. If there are any problems, we call the Venjakob service and they take care of it for us. Now we have already adjusted everything well. Last but not least, we have the speed of the belt. We can adjust it down here. Now we are just at 2.5 meters per minute. I would like to go a little faster to 3 meters a minute. Now we have set that already. The cool thing about the program is that when you want to set something, you just press the enter button and it's already saved by itself. It will be shown here below and then you can start. Yes, that's it for the end, and I wish you a lot of fun with the VEN Spray 1.